Afternoon, professor. Am I audible?
Yes. Yes.
Sir, next is Shelly Jain, sir. Shelly Jain.
Good afternoon, respected professors and my dear colleagues. I am Dr. Shelly Jain, first year PGT Department of General Medicine from Arjikar Medical College and Hospital. My topic for today is hypopituitarism, a missed medical cause of mental disorders. Psychiatric illness associated with pituitary tumors or other lesions leading to hypopituitarism has been ascribed to the resulting hormonal deficiencies, which is an indirect effect of surgical or radiotherapeutic intervention or a direct result of hypopituitarism. But the diagnosis is often missed. Hyponatremia is the most common disorder of electrolytes encountered in clinical practice, but hyponatremia as a presenting manifestation of empty cella syndrome is rare. The term empty cella refers to the herniation of subarachnoid space within the cella in patients with no history of pituitary tumor, surgery, or radiotherapy. My patient was a 52-year-old non-hypertensive, non-diabetic lady who presented to the emergency in an obtundent state with a history of recurrent vomiting for the past 1 week. Patient was on antipsychotic and antidepressant for 3 to 4 years. She also had a history of miscarriage during her first pregnancy, that was 32 years back, following which she had severe blood loss and was transfused with 3 to 4 units of PRBC. She attained menopause 3 years back and she had 2 sons. On examination, the patient was obese. She had dry and thin skin. GCS was E2, V2, M4. She was hypotensive, hypoglycemic, and her plantars were bilaterally extensor and calf muscles were stiff. On day one, the blood reports were she was hyponatremic, hypokalemia was there. LDH was high, CRP was high, and urine for spot sodium was sent, which was 30. We went for NCCT brain and it did not show any significant abnormalities there. So we went for sodium and potassium replacement. On day two, we sent some other hormonal tests like serum TSH, total T3, total T4, serum morning cortisol, all of which were lower than the normal limits. So we started the patient on glucocorticoid and thyroid hormone replacements on the following days. On day three, we went for MRI P+C brain and MRI of pituitary gland and hypothalamus. We showed marked thinning of pituitary gland with widening of cella, which was filled with TSH. Further on, we went for serum FSH, serum LH, serum prolactin, IGF-1, all of which were lower than the normal limit. The short prolactin test, the patient passed that response as well. So on day 6 onwards, we put the patient on maintenance therapy and she was stabilized and discharged on day 10. And she was not given any kind of antidepressant or antipsychotics and she's followed up till date. Discussion for pituitary axis hormone receptors are present in the central nervous system, hence they can have an effect on the structure and function of brain. For example, the growth hormone axis has an important role in neuronal development and function. Several studies found that pituitary axis deficiencies have a negative effect on functions of central nervous system, such as cognition and mood. Glucocorticoids have shown to reverse the impaired water diuresis of this disorder by increasing the renal excretion of solute-free water. Psychiatric literature reports good symptomatic outcome with adequate hormone replacements like cortisol, thyroxine, and steroids. My conclusion is that occasionally mental disorders might be a result of endocrinological perturbations, which might remain obscure unless we actively search for it, and hence correction of these hormonal disturbances can lead to prompt reversal of her psychotic and depressing symptoms. Thank you, sir.